It's taking, you see the right coming there, it's coming soon. Yes, we are. Welcome, welcome. Good morning, good afternoon, and welcome. Thank you for tuning in today. I am Ambassador Verene Lawson here in our local studio, right here with Dr. Pepe today. How are you, Dr. Pepe?
I am doing fine, doing fine.
Thank you very much for joining me.
In the actual studio.
Thank you very much for joining. I'm telling our audience today that you are in for a treat, because today Dr. Pepe is going to be sharing a powerful, powerful blood of the king for our 10-minute daily plug-in. So thank you very much for tuning in, Dr. Pepe. The floor is yours.
Thank you so much. Well, and again, thank you and Brian for always hosting us. You know, every time we travel through this area, we are always welcome at your home. Thank you. And of course, likewise, you're welcome at our home anytime that you guys want.
Thank you.
Well, I am so excited. Thank you so much for tuning in to MBN. And it's right here in Savannah, Georgia, broadcasting throughout the rest of this world. Always a pleasure working with you. This is one of Dr. Monroe's favorite daughters, all right? You were the official singer in Israel. You know, yes. When we did baptism, he would say, Veronique, okay, start
so
the singing.
So true.
Yes. Well,
so today, our audience, Dr. Pepe, is going to be addressing this book. I don't know about you, but I would love you to buy the book. And this is what he's going to be covering today on this 10-minute daily plug-in, The Blood of the King. Remember, I was talking to you earlier about the 7 gates or the 9 gates that we have in the body. He is going to be covering that today.
Definitely. Well, we just want to remind you guys, we are going to be meeting in Nassau, Bahamas, continuing the legacy from Dr. Monroe at the IAKCM, which is the International Association for Kingdom Churches and Ministries, there in Nassau, Bahamas, the place where God lives, all right? And we are continuing with the Kingdom Training Conference. Mark your calendar, July the 28th through the 30th, 2021. That's this year, July the 28th to the 30th. 2021, and we're going to be right there at Bahamas Faith Ministries.
Wow.
And we're going to be hosting the Kingdom Training Conference out there. You can see our senior hosts out there, Dr. Dave Burrows and Dr. Peter Morgan, and I work as the vice president of the organization. So register, find out a little bit more about it, and come down and be with us there in Nassau, Bahamas, in person. But we are also broadcasting it, Veronique, so people can watch whatever part of the world that you're in, it will be live too as well. So come and be a part of this conference.
Great, awesome.
I am going to also be hosting a short seminar on June the 3rd through June the 13th. And it's going to be dealing with those 7 areas, those 7 doors, those 7 openings that happened to mankind when Adam and Eve fell.
Mm.
And those doors were supposed to remain closed, but they opened.
Exactly.
The door of sickness and diseases was now open. And this particular seminar is going to teach you how to shut those doors back from leukemia, cancer, tumors, poverty, all those 7 areas that have been opened to us. So you have to register, and there's some information. You have to go to pepiramnathintl.com. And you can register for this conference. We're going to provide you with an electronic copy of the book.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to give you all of the PowerPoints, and then you're going to spend 15 minutes person one-on-one with me in regards to the struggles that you have. And we're going to show you how to apply the blood over the doorpost and make sure that you're healed and delivered during this particular short period of time. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what I'm going to do is talk briefly about, you know, what's in this book, you know, out here. And, you know, we see in Genesis chapter 4 and verse 10, where God said, and he said, what have you done? All right. He's speaking now to Cain. The voice of your brother's blood cries out to me from the ground. This tells us that blood has a voice.
Mm-hmm.
It has a sound. In fact, Veronique, when God made, when God was speaking to Mary, he told Mary, you're going to have a child. You're going to have a baby. And this child will be called Jesus of Nazareth.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this child is supposed to shed his blood to save all the entire human race. But you cannot save the human race with contaminated blood. So he could not use the lineage of human blood from Adam or Abraham or anybody else. He had to use the blood of himself. So what did God do to make this blood? He spoke into Mary's womb. Now, we know from studies at MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, that sound or words can actually be converted into electricity.
Yeah.
Now, they have found in a study that when a sperm is released to the egg, the first thing the sperm does to fertilize the egg is to release an electrical impulse. Electricity is released from the head of the sperm onto the egg. Then once that electricity hits the egg, there is some zinc that is trapped in the egg that causes an explosion. So you have light that is produced. Now, why this is important? Because the spoken word of God is a sound. And when you put a sound in the right incubator or vacuum, it can be converted into electricity. So God's voice or his sound was converted into electricity, fertilized, now hit the zinc of Mary's egg in the womb and causes explosion, producing light. Now, if you take light, and you condense light, you press light down, you slow light down, it becomes liquefied. So you have a liquid light, which is now we call congealed light in the laboratory. The congealed light, now if you do some further compression of that congealed light, the first color it takes on is the color red. So what does God do? God made blood, his own blood, put it into the egg of Mary that produced Jesus. The body was Jesus, but inside was Christ. And inside of this man carried the blood of God, not the blood of humankind, not the failed contaminated blood of humankind, but the blood of God himself. And this is why blood cries out. Blood has a voice. You know, when blood is bombarded by infrared light, and I think it's on your screen, it something happens, you know?
Yeah.
Blood begins now to respond back to infrared light, and that's all found in the book. It's found in the book. It comes back to us at the speed of sound. So when light touches blood, it produces sound. When the light of God came that day at Abel's blood, the light touched that blood, and that blood began to speak. So when you apply blood, you must know that blood, the blood of Jesus Christ, actually speak. Eric Stroll and his colleague at Ryerson University actually conducted the same experiment by bombarding blood with infrared light.
Wow.
And it came back at the speed of sound, telling the scientists and telling the medical doctors what the diseases are. Amen. So again, when you apply blood, it is very, very important for you to recognize that the blood that you just applied will speak on your behalf. Now, if you see on the screen again, here's a tumor. A tumor is made, or it makes its own blood vessels, because even a tumor needs blood to actually stay alive. But since blood now travels to the tumor, it actually needs, it would respond to sound, because blood was made from sound. So if you send the blood of the voice of God, you can actually destroy this tumor, because the blood will carry through. All right. Amen. Amen. Now, I want you to see something. I'm so excited about this ambassador.
Yeah.
Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 24 is on your screen. It says, and to Jesus, the mediator, the one who stands in the gap of the new covenant, and to the blood of its sprinkling, that what? Speaketh better things than that of Abel. So Abel's blood now was crying out for revenge. But Jesus' blood cries out to sanctify you, to atone you, to redeem you, to intercede on your behalf, to cleanse you. That's what Jesus' blood does. So
thank
when you apply blood over those doorposts, he's going to cry out for you.
Wow.
Amen. So say with me, those of you that are watching right now, the blood of Jesus. I apply the blood of Jesus.
I apply the blood of Jesus.
Now that blood is speaking on your behalf.
And it's speaking on my behalf.
Now, you know, the first blood transfusion was taken place. I think I may have a screen of it, but it's in another teaching. But in the laboratory, when we want to test diseases and we want to know something about human blood, the only blood we can actually use is sheep's blood. Lamb's blood. And the first blood transfusion took place out in I believe it's in Italy. And there was a sick man that they used the blood of the lamb the animal lamb now mm-hmm. to do a blood transfusion. And guess what happened? He came back to life. He was alive. He was well. But the king now was very jealous. There was a king back in that time that was very jealous of this one particular scientist. Now, you have to buy the book to find out who the scientist
you
is.
You need to buy this book to find out who is that scientist.
Yes.
Scientist. Sorry.
So the king now, you know, he's so jealous. He's so angry. So he stopped the blood transfusion of lamb. So what does the scientist do? He has to go now to use another blood, and he used cow's blood. Immediately, Ambassador, as soon as they put this, they did this transfusion with cow's blood, the patient died immediately.
Goodness.
So there is a reason why God used lamb's blood in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, of course, he uses the blood of his son. In Romans chapter 1, verse 20, the Bible says, "For since the creation of this world, his invisible attributes, that means the characteristic, the nature of who God is, mm-hmm. his eternal power and divine nature itself, have been clearly seen," he says, "being understood through what has been made, that is the plants, the animals, the lamb's blood, mm-hmm. fossils and rock," he says, "if you shut them up, even the rock will cry out." So now we are without excuse. God has planted and placed inside of us his voice inside of all of nature. We are surrounded with the blood of the lamb. We are surrounded with the voice of the Lord. So I encourage you, get this book out there, learn how to apply the blood and shut those seven doors that have been opened illegally over your life.
Yeah. And then you heard it well. So please get this book. Get this book and get all the material of Dr. Pepe, as you could see it right now, even on the screen. And then that has been our privilege today to come to you live with this short series of the blood of the king. And as he said, he's going to be doing a seminar on that one on June 3rd through June 13th. Okay, then we're gonna put under the comment box all the information that you may have need of. So until we see you, we're coming back in about an hour for our royal etiquette. So stay tuned. Yes. And then we give you right now the Queen's salute. See you at the top. Thank you very much, Dr. Pepe.
Thank you for having me.
For us to have you again back on this show today. And then we can't wait to have you back again for a long period of time.
Looking forward to it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
Blessing. Bye-bye. Bye.